Here we're going to derive the equation for osmotic pressure based on equilibrium. And the idea is represented here. If we have a container with a membrane, and so this membrane is only permeable to the solvent, and we'll use water. So the left side is the solvent, water. The right side is water plus some solute, for example, a salt. And notice there's a difference in height of the liquids because we're at equilibrium. This height difference is the osmotic pressure. And so the height difference, delta P, which we represent as pi, osmotic pressure, density, the water, G, and then the height. So height in appropriate units to make the units come out correct. Well, what we're interested in is how we calculate the osmotic pressure. Can we predict what that height would be? And the criteria is that we have equilibrium, that the fugacity of water on the left side, which is pure water, is equal to the fugacity of water on the right side. And I'm going to use this symbol that's used in a number of books to indicate that the water is in a mixture. And so the fugacity of water on the left side, I'm going to write fugacity of water that's evaluated at the pressure on the left side. So let's take the right side. We have the mole fraction of water times the activity coefficient of water times the fugacity of water, but now at the pressure on the right side. And fugacity in the liquid phase is a function pressure, but it's a weak function. And so the right side, mole fraction of water, this we're going to set equal to 1. And the reason we're doing that is because XW is close to 1. So XW means we have a dilute solution, and therefore this is not 1, but maybe it's, let's say, 0.96. And so then it's a very good approximation. The mole fraction is close to 1, the activity coefficient is going to be 1. Fugacity of water at this higher pressure is going to be fugacity of water at the pressure on the left side, and then a correction, that's the pointing correction, which is an exponential, and it's the volume of water times the pressure difference. So pressure on the right side minus pressure on the left side divided by the gas constant and absolute temperature. So that's the pointing correction. Well, now if I write this, this term cancels this term. So what I have is an expression for, and remember this term here is my osmotic pressure. So I can rearrange this. So when I rearranged about the exponential to the other side, it became a negative in the exponential. Now I can take the log of both sides. So we have log in the mole fraction, and then on the right side we have pi times the volume, it's a molar volume, over RT. Now we can make an approximation because the mole fraction of water is close to 1, to a pretty good approximation. The log of it is just the mole fraction minus 1, just the approximation that, like I say, is very good when the mole fraction is close to 1. Well, also I can say, of course, the mole fraction of the solute plus the mole fraction of water is equal to 1. So this is minus the mole fraction of the solute. And now I have minuses on both sides. I can rearrange this equation, and I can write it as the osmotic pressure times the volume of the water, the liquid volume, mole fraction of the solute, gas constant, absolute temperature. And so the mole fraction looks very much like ideal gas law, right? So this is the osmotic pressure, and this is the solute mole fraction. And this is a liquid volume, so it's a molar volume, in this case, of water, liquid water. Absolute temperature and the gas constant. And so from simple equilibrium expression, setting fugacities equal, we can derive the osmotic pressure equation.